know, they cut my head open, and we look, and the three of us, it was Kim, Ashley, and I, and there was nothing on his head, no stitches, no blood, anything. And he just lunged forward, and it just stuck with me for days. Like, his eyes, it wasn't right. Like, something wasn't right. That was the weirdest thing, and it, yeah, bothered me for days. And then the Amityville show or pictures or anything about it showed up for about a week straight.
Wow. Marie says, holy crap.
Yeah, I know. I still, when I say it, doesn't sound like it could actually happen, but it is.
Okay, before we go around the table and talk about that, I want to ask Pam, what is the number one thing on your bucket list? What number one location that you'd love to go? Where do you want to go?
Where would I love to go? See, I'm kind of lucky. I get to go everywhere, but...
if it could be anywhere in the world, anywhere.
But if we're talking, like, scary down in, like, really scary, maybe, like, Transylvania.
I'm with you.
I'm with you, too.
Yeah, something like that. Like, mm-hmm. Scary.
Amy?
What's your... Hawaii seems kind of scary right now.
Okay, we're talking paranormal.
Oh, paranormal.
Might be paranormal.
My own house. No, you know, I don't know. The place where the ghost hunts, guys... The demon showed up. That was pretty, and the little Irish guy got all freaked out and ran and said, he went nuts and said, it's getting you, it's gonna get you. That place seemed kind of funny. I don't know otherwise. So far I'm having fun with what we're doing.
Kelly, where do you wanna go?
A castle, overseas, because I love castles, because ever since I lived in one when I was little, I like it. So it has to be a castle somewhere in Germany, Ireland, England, wherever. That's what I want to do.
Michelle?
Well, I agree with Pam, so I would say a castle,
too. Yeah, I think I think we're all going to start playing the trip then.
Well, yeah, I think so.
I have one that we talked about on a couple other radio shows that I was on, and it was people thought I was kind of crazy. I want to go to Auschwitz.
Yeah, see? Yeah. My heritage.
I know.
Not happening.
I heard Normandy, the battle, Normandy Beach is really...
Marie says, mine is anywhere RIP and Ghost Hunts USA is.
We love you.
Mark says Romania.
Oh, nice.
Friends, that would be the
Dracula's castle. So what I'd like to do, since we're talking about all this before we get too far, Pam... Can you let folks know a little bit what Ghost Hunts USA is and where they could go to check out the places? If, you know, I know we have a big, long list on Ghost Hunts USA. It could be on somebody's bucket list and how they can go there and maybe get tickets to, you know, scratch it off their bucket list.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, that's what we do. We want to give that experience to people who can't do that on a regular basis or, you know, able to do it. We are the largest, ghost hunt event company in the U.S. So we do. We go to about 20-something locations, I think. I think it's over 20 now. We go all over the country, everywhere from California to Missouri to Kansas to Iowa, Texas, Louisiana, Pennsylvania, everywhere in between. We try to find the most haunted and horrifying locations. We try to get people to come in and actually experience ghost hunting. I know a lot of people watch those shows and they want to do it. And that's how I was. That's how I started. I'm like, oh, I really want to do this. I want to try this. And it's amazing because we're able to give that experience to people.
So the website for Ghost Hunts USA is ghosthuntsusa.com. You can go there.
Ghosthuntsusa.com.
Go there.
And to check out the locations, there's a whole tab up top that just says locations. You can look at the list of all the locations, and you click on the location, it shows you all of the event dates available, and you can purchase tickets that way too.
And I do want to let people know, because a lot of people don't know this, and that's how we did it, because we went to Ashmore Estates. When they want to purchase a ticket, they only have to do that deposit to start with. So it's not like you have to come up with that money right away, and then you can pay it and get down, you know. So I just kind of wanted to, you know, let people know, if even if it's $129 or if it's $49, You just put the deposit down, and then you're able to pay that in increments because you guys are very good with taking those payments. We've had some people actually over at Edinburgh Manor that had to, that came in the night of the hunt because they had to wait for a paycheck, and we took their payment, and they were able to hunt with us. It was an amazing family. So, I mean, Ghost Hunts USA is really good by doing that kind of stuff. So, it's easy to get the tickets and do what you love and get stuff off your bucket list. And, I mean, I have not seen any other company do it that way. They want everything up front.
Well, and the other
guys... Yeah, I mean, that gives you that chance. And, yeah, the $30, most of the locations, some of them are a little bit more depending on which location. But it is the $30 to book your spot. And then you have 4 weeks before the event to pay it. So even if you wanted to pay in increments and smaller amounts, you could do that too.
And that's what I love, because you are able to do that, and it does help people who are, you know, kind of living check by check, but still are able to, you know, have a night out and do something like this.
Well, and the other nice thing is, what people don't realize is, you've got people who are experienced who are going to go with you on vigils, but we have tons of equipment, all different types, from low tech to high tech, things that people aren't going to be able to have on their own. And most sites aren't going to have. So if you go on into the site on your own, you're just going to wander around. Where we're actually going to let you see equipment, try it. It's going to be really cool.
Yeah, exactly. And because we're so awesome, too.
I do have to tell you something kind of cute, though. When we did the tally house this weekend, we had a guy who came in. He'd never been on a hunt before. He had won a fantasy football league pool, and he used all that money to buy all this equipment so he could go ghost hunting, because that was what he wanted to do. And he came in with all this really cool equipment, and you probably saw it on the site, but he's the guy that got scratched.
And it was so cute. He goes, "Can you guys teach me how to use this?" And, but everybody was willing to help, and that's what makes these hunts great. You know, one thing I know we tell a lot of folks is, you know, like you said, they're watching it on TV. So they think as soon as we walk in, you know, they're going to see an apparition come down the stairs or something happen. But we've noticed now that we're getting more people to kind of get themselves in tune with their own bodies, they're actually experiencing more. They're not actually just using the video camera or the recorder. And doing the vigil with the EMF detectors, I mean, I think we pretty much looked like Sam's Club selling it when we had it all on the table. But it was just amazing because people were trying to listen to their bodies. They're like, you know, I can feel my hair moving, or I heard a whisper, because they took that couple minutes to really listen instead of worrying about, hey, is this machine telling me something? So it was really awesome that more and more people are starting to understand that.
Right, because your body is the best tool.
Oh, yes.
You can feel the changes. And, you know, that is the energy. The energy you bring into it is what you're going to get out of it.
Yep.
So if you go in there with an open mind and you say, let me feel this, let me see what's around, you know, not relying on everything, EMF detectors. And I've been touched in everything without an EMF detector going off.
Me too.
I've had, you know, experiences of seeing things in front of me that just appeared without an EMF detector going off, without anything going off. I mean, that's just, you got to pay attention to your surroundings and put the energy into it, and that's what you get out of it.
You know, one of the best things I like about ghost hunts, especially when we started working with you guys, it's the education level. It's not just go in and jump in and start hunting. No, each individual person that is doing a vigil or even just sitting down talking with people is doing their best to educate people on exactly what to do, what's not right. You know, just it's not just thrown into the fire and go for it. It's okay, slow down. This is what we're doing. This is why we're doing this. And this is, you know, there's an education out there of not everybody is going to see an apparition. Not everybody's going to, you know, feel something, hear something right away. And the fact that one of the biggest things we always try to teach them is we don't pay ghosts. It's impossible for us to pay a ghost to do anything. I wouldn't even know how to write that check, to tell you the honest truth.
Invisible ink. I had to go there, sorry.
Write it in powder.
I laughed at it when you left.
Oh, no. It's either use invisible ink or badge powder. One of the two.
It is the badge powder. I feel it does make sense because, well, I mean, you're the whole thing that Andrew said. He heard about it and he
But you know, just the educating people on why we do this. I mean, we've talked to a lot of people that just sit back and go, "You guys are nuts. You're crazy. It doesn't exist." I don't see how people can actually say that until the A, either one, try it, or B, look back in their past where possibly it's already happened to them, and they just have learned as an adult to block things out.
Well,
open your eyes.
You don't want to. It's something that a lot of people can't fathom. You know, it's not. You know, when I tell people who have a ghost hunter, I don't try to convince people that they're a ghost. I don't. I just say, you know what? If you just experience it.
Yep.
You just have to. People say, is it true? Yes. I could probably write a book on all the experiences I've seen, I felt, I witnessed, the crazy stuff that happens. You know, you can't convince somebody.
And not even just
those that I love, actually. They're my favorite, the skeptics yet believe. They
like that guy we had.
They don't know, and they still, even though they've experienced, so we've had several guests come back and they keep coming back. And they still say they're a skeptic. But they've experienced things that they still say they're a skeptic.
Yeah, but that's okay. You know, I mean, I figure be a skeptic, at least be open. But I think people who come in and don't want to experience anything are those folks that are probably not going it because they really don't want to.
Yeah, and that's right. But then there's those that are like, well, don't know until I see it, but I've experienced it.
Yeah.
I love them because they are really truly there to experience it.
Well,
and they truly want to understand it. We don't have answers. None of us ever have answers. That's why we keep doing it. If we had answers, we'd be like, okay, you know.
Exactly.
Nobody has the answers.
Well, and we've been teaching a lot on our hunts, too, which was really great because everybody wanted to do it at the Sally House, is we're teaching people how to debunk some things, you know, and they really got into it because it started making them start thinking, okay, this is not part of it, but this could be, and we felt like the experience was different because, like, when the coffee pot was clicking, even though it was just a generic coffee pot, two of the EMF detectors would go off in the living room. And it would just be a little tiny click. And then first everybody thought, and everybody started trying to figure out why. And when we all came to consensus of, oh, it's the coffee pot, everybody was like proud because they debunked something, you know. But it made them realize when we were continuing with the hunt, they were paying more attention to all the other stuff going on.
Right. Yeah, exactly. And there's times that we question it. Well, what was that? we have to look at it this way.
Oh, yeah. I mean, and I think that's what's good about Ghost Hunts USA, you know. Yeah, you get people who complain, well, I paid all this money, but I didn't see nothing. Well, again, you know, we can't promise you're going to see, but, you know, we're not sitting there going, oh, look, there's a ghost there, and we have a sheet hanging in the corner. We don't play those kind of games, and that's what I like, you know. We want you to have the real experience.
One of the hardest...
We'd rather you have fun, like, come have fun, laugh,
one of the biggest things that, you know, that I've kind of tried to start teaching people is, it's hunting a ghost is, and I hate to steal Josh's little spiel he does, but it is like fishing. You got to sit still. It's not going to just happen right away. You can't cast out and all of a sudden bring in a boatload of fish. You got to wait for it. And you got to build the energy, and you've got to get things set up, and you've got to, it's almost got to come to you.
Yeah, exactly. You never know what you're going to do. There's times that it's really, really active and don't stop, and there's times that it's quiet. We can't guarantee, but, you know, we try our best.
Yeah, I don't know what it is, but since we've been talking to Pam, I just keep getting these visions, and it's Pam. It's about you with some girl. I don't know what it is.
Oh, my God. I hope to close off.
You were naked. Why were you naked? And is there a YouTube video or something? Because I keep seeing you naked, like with this girl, and something about a YouTube or a video that doesn't exist. What the heck is all that?
Are you really my own guy?
Something about fire.
Yeah.
It's like a popular influence thing right now. Okay, you really want to tell you this?
Yeah, I just keep eating the word cap